Hey, so today I wanted to put a super on the beehive because last time I noticed that they were starting to build some wax up into the tops of the lid in the lid. So today I'm going to put a Queen Excluder, which is this thing here. This is a metal queen excluder, and the idea of the queen excluder is it goes on top of the brood chamber or the bottom box or the top box, and it prevents the queen from coming through. The metal wires are spaced so that workers can come through, but the queen has got a rather large abdomen. She won't be able to get through and stay in the bottom box. And the idea is you don't want the queen to come up and lay eggs in the honey chambers. Otherwise, you'll be killing lots and lots of unborn bees. And so there's a bit of a controversy, not controversy, just a bit of talk whether queen excluders reduce the honey. It probably does, just the amount of honey that you have probably does, but the difference is very small. It's about, you'll lose what, 5 kilos out of 50. Is that going to make that much of a difference? I don't think so. Yeah, so that's the queen excluder, and I'm going to be putting in 6 brand new frames, which I just built the other day. And what I'm going to do is a quick experiment on some foundationless frames. And these have got no foundation. Well, all it's got is a little starter strip up the top, which is actually made from a sheet of foundation. And what it is, I just cut a little bit of the foundation. And I just use some hot wax, melted wax, to just make sure it sits inside that groove. Oops, I'll try and grab that. There it goes. So the bees will actually, so you can see I've just put some melted wax, just so that I can tack it along and just make sure it stays inside the track there. The bees will extend this out and hopefully build, this is upside down, but yeah, so the bees will extend this out and out to the sides, because you see it's a very thin strip. And they'll extend it out this way to the width of the bar itself, and hopefully next week we'll start seeing some natural comb. Now the thing is, with natural comb, we'll go into it next time, is we want to ensure that you don't hold the frames this way, because the natural comb has got no support. Unlike this one, where it's got wires embedded in the wax. So I did this with an electric embedder. So pretty, which I built myself. It's maybe gone a bit too much on that one, but so the wire is actually embedded in the wax, and the bees will build their comb around that wax. You see the wire runs through in a zigzag fashion, up and down, up and down. Yeah, so I've got 6 frames of wax and 2 of frames with no foundation. What I did is I put a little NF there for no foundation. And I'm going to put that into the hive. Now the idea of putting, ideally, when you're putting in something with no foundation, okay, so if you're putting in a frame with no foundation, you should checkerboard it and put it between two frames with wax, because that way it'll reduce the amount of cross comb that you'll get. So because there's a fair bit of space, as you can see down there, fair bit of space, there's nothing preventing the bees from building wax this way across, which is not what you want, because otherwise you'll be impossible to take out without damaging the comb. Even better would be to actually put two frames which are fully drawn. That way the proper bee space is adhered to, and the bees won't be drawing cross comb this way. So the bee space is very important, because bees tend to build, if you have, for example, your frames like that, guarantee that you're going to get some cross combing in there. So it's always a very good idea to keep your frames tight up against each other to avoid cross combing. The edges, or the shoulders, or whatever you want to call it, of these frames are built so that this the proper bee space is used. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a couple of frames of drawn comb from the bottom and bring them up and put these empty, no foundation frames between them, so that way I can guarantee that they're going to be drawing straight comb. Okay, let's get that going. Just want to show you some more of that burr comb. So the bees have built all this in 1 week in the top of my lid. That's the lid, and they've built that up. And I just didn't have time to get back in the hive, and I actually cleaned that up all last week, and I thought, who knows, they might take a little bit of time, but they're actually going gangbusters, and they're just killing it. They're just building so much comb, they need more room, so I've actually put another super with 8 frames in there, in the actual hive, and this is 1 week's work. Just already starting to backfill it with honey, and again I've got to scrape that out. Unfortunately, I don't want them to build in the lid, because it starts getting a bit messy and very hard to work with. So I'll go clean that up.